Hi, I am Christer Fuglesang of the STS-128 crew, and you are watching NASA TV.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you.
And good morning, Discovery, and good morning today, Christer.
Good morning, and thanks for that wonderful music. Another wonderful day and round and wonderful
skies of blue.
Danny Olivas and Christopher Fuglesang making final checks to their spacesuits.
The bright, blessed
we are
day,
just about at vacuum here, ready to have those
night,
suits placed on internal battery power for the
and
start
I
of
think
today's
to
space
myself,
going.
What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow.
The outer thermal cover has popped open,
so
and the hatch is in the process
in
of being
sky
opened.
Also on the faces of people going by, I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
All right, there they are.
Yes, I think to myself,
okay, sending forward to
IV equalization hatch to not up. Chris, we're going to remove the safer from you if you can hang on to this handle here.
Yeah.
Everybody's upside down.
Yeah. All right, Christer. Good job.
Hey, CJ. Thanks a lot.
You bet.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Danielle,
that's called teamwork.
That was some real teamwork.
Big teamwork. Ground, robo, everybody.
At the Johnson Space Center in Houston, USA, ESA astronaut Christer Fuglesang is busy preparing for his second mission into space. His rigorous training regime spans many different facilities, each designed to replicate conditions on board the International Space Station. This 53-year-old Swedish physicist has already visited the ISS for real. During this mission, Fuglesang made three spacewalks. He spent a total of 18 hours and 14 minutes outside the station carrying out maintenance and construction tasks. In all, a picture-perfect mission, demonstrating a level of expertise that Christer hopes to reach again.
Whatever I did was the first time. Now the challenge is to kind of think of new things which can create interest and show in more ways what it is to live and work and do experience in space.
During his second flight into space, Christer Fuglesang is scheduled to carry out many scientific experiments and will again have the privilege of walking in space.
It's a challenge and it's an interesting challenge.
During the mission, Christer will also be meeting up with another ESA astronaut, Frank de Winner from Belgium, who was launched from Baikonur on the 27th of May. For the first time, the station will be occupied by a six-strong crew, which includes astronauts from four different space agencies, ESA, NASA, Roscosmos, and the Canadian Space Agency. For now, Krister Fuglsang is staying focused on his training and concentrating on his role as a mission specialist. However, for him, space is much more than just a job.
I've always been interested in space, and I just see in front of me how eventually people, humanity kind of moves out and just not only living on Earth, but in other bodies as well, and Mars, I guess, is the first time. But also, it's an adventure, and to be part of this post-adventure, the future for humankind. And finally, it's research. We do research up there, and my background, I'm a scientist.
One last thing. Frank is missing some Belgian food, but I have some Swedish candy for you. This is Swedish race cars floating around in space.
Krister and Frank, the European Space Agency is very proud of your excellent work.